Hi, so it's in today's tutorial. I'm gonna use a brand that is owned by a brother of a friend of mine, which is YC Collection. And he puts a lot of effort to it, and the brand is really, really good. You can only get it online. So I hope you like the look so you can actually buy the brand. By the way, this is not sponsored. It's just that I like the brand. So let's right jump to the tutorial. Hi sweets, for today's tutorial I'm gonna use a couple of things that for me are new, and one of them is this one. It is a Enhanced Radiance Minimize Pores Even Skin Tone Primer in a facial mask. I'm not a big of a fan of not prepping my face properly. Let's give it a try, but I'm not feeling it. So let's start. I already opened the package. This is it. Now we wait for 5 minutes for this to do what it's supposed to do. The 5 minutes have already passed, so I'm going to take off this and rinse my face how the instruction says, and we're gonna start with the makeup. I don't see any minimizing of pores at all, but at least I have a smooth, clean surface. So let's see how everything behaves on top of it and see if I really like or dislike this cheap mask. So for starters, I'm going with my Physician Formula Refreshment. And now with my Physician Formula Rosé All Day. And for foundation, I'm going with my CoverGirl Vitalist Healthy Elixir in 732. And for the application of it, I'm going with my Eco Tools Cover Complexion. I'm applying it in Tapping Motions all over my face. Remember to drag a little bit your foundation to your neck so it matched the rest of your skin. And be careful with your hairline. It doesn't look good when you get foundation to your hairline. It looks messy. Always apply a little bit of foundation to your ears because you look like you're wearing a mask. That doesn't look flattering at all. And for concealer, I'm using my Benefit Erase Paste in number 1 Fair. I am kind of enamored with this again. I have forgotten all over it and I don't know why I grabbed it, and now I'm loving it again. I'm applying my concealer, first of all, where I want to conceal, and second of it, with the places where I want to be brightened a little bit. And today I'm going to blend it with my Sephora Pro 57 brush. First my under eye, my cupid's bow, my chin, my smile lines, the bridge of my nose, and my forehead. And to blend everything together, I'm going with my Crown Flat Bronzer brush to diffuse any visible line that I may have. And now to set my under eye, today I'm going to use my Rimmel London State Matte Long Lasting Pressed Powder, and I'm going to apply it with my S. Elm Mist Glam. Set my under eye, the bridge of my nose, my forehead, keep my cupid's bow, my smile lines, and my chin. For bronzer, I'm going to use my Essence Sun Club Matte Bronzing Powder in Dark Skin with my RLM Moda Pro 130 brush. I'm going to bronze my face a little bit. I'm starting the hollows of my cheeks, my chin, and my nose, only in this half sides of it because I have a really thin bridge of nose and I don't have to contour or to bronze it a lot, and my forehead. And remember to connect the three parts of your face that you already bronzed, which is your forehead, the hollows of your cheek, and your jewel. To set my entire face, I'm going with my Maybelline Fit Me Loose Finishing Powder in Light 15, and with my MAC 150 brush, I'm gonna set my entire face, or the rest of the face that doesn't have any powder in it. For blush, I'm going with this Stila Custom Color Blush in Self Adjustable Coral. I don't know if Stila still have this, but I really like this color. It is like this rosy, peachy, shimmering color. And using my Crown blush brush, I'm gonna apply it in my cheeks. I like a glowy, healthy skin, and I'm gonna use as a finishing powder my Physician Formula Useful Wear, and I'm gonna apply it with my MAC 150 brush, but I'm gonna dust it in my face. Eyebrows, I'm going with my Brown Gal by Tonya Crooks. This is the Convertible Brow 02. It looks like this. I'm going with my Linda Halbert 333 brush. I'm gonna do like an ombre look to my eyebrows, because first I'm gonna start with the lightest shade. That one, I'm gonna apply it on the beginning of my eyebrows. And now for the other half of my eyebrows, I'm going with the second color, which is this brown grayish tone. And with this one, I'm going to draw my arch. Now I'm feeling my brows, or actually half of it. And to finish and give them a little bit of definition, I'm going with the darkest color. And I'm gonna finish the tail of my eyebrow with this color. And now to set my eyebrows, I'm using this Wonder Brow One Step Brow Gel. I'm using a wand to apply it to my eyebrows. I'm packing it. And then I'm gonna brush my eyebrows upwards first. Now downwards. Today I'm going with my YC Collection Earthy Neutrals Eyeshadow Travel Palette, which is this one. And she looks like this inside. I'm gonna try to do like kind of a not a natural look, but at least a daily wearable look. So let's start applying a little bit of concealer all over my lid. Using my Aralan Moda Pro 430 brush, I think I'm gonna start with this rose color. I'm applying it a little bit higher than my natural crease. Remember that I have hooded eyes, so I can't use my natural crease to apply my transition color. Now I'm gonna use this kind of a terracotta color. And with my Linda Halbert 304 brush, I'm gonna pack the brush a little bit, and I'm gonna start to apply it in my outer V. First, I'm tapping it in my outer V to get the pigment where I want it to be. And now I'm gonna blend it in so I don't have any visible harsh line. I'm blending it to my crease color. Now I'm going with this bronzy shade. And that one, I'm gonna apply it with a flat brush if I can find one. And I'm going with my Crown Oval Fluff brush. I'm packing the brush, and I'm applying it in the rest of my lid. I'm doing it in tapping motions, and at the same time, since I just took once from the pan, I'm trying to blend the line between the two colors. I'm gonna take a little bit of the darkest shade here to give a little more definition to my eye look, but it's not much, it's just a touch of it. And I'm gonna do it with my Basanti Contour Eyeshadow in number 4 brush. I'm applying it with the tip of the brush, and I'm pressing it to my outer V. And now in circular motions, I'm gonna blend the little bit of shadow that I'm applying, because as I told you, it's not a lot what I want. It's just a touch of it. I want a little more light to my lid. So I'm going with this gold color. And I'm gonna apply to my inner corner, but I'm not gonna leave it just there. I'm gonna tap it a little bit more to the start of my lid. My bottom part, I'm going with the light terracotta shade and using my Vasanti Contour number 4 brush. I'm going to dust it in my bottom lashes. And I'm going to take a little bit of the darkest color in the palette. And with a smudge brush, I'm going to apply a little bit over, literally on top of my bottom lashes, but just to the half of it. With my ColourPop Gel Creme Liner in Best O. I'm going to apply this pen liner to my lid, but really close to my lashes. And now I'm gonna tighten my lashes line. For highlighter, I'm gonna use a palette from the same brand that I use the eyeshadows. This one is called Nanlix Shine Bright Highlight Palette. She's a local makeup artist, so I try my best to support. I think I'm gonna mix this two. This yellowish color with this bronzy one. And for it, I'm gonna use my Luxie 640 brush. I'm gonna apply in the high points of my face, first my cheeks, the bridge of my nose, my cupid's bow, and a little bit above my eyebrows. Oh, I forgot to tell you, that palette was a limited edition. I'm not sure if they still have it on stock, but the eyeshadow palette, I'm sure that they still have it. So I have 3 colors for lips from the same brand, these 3. And I think I'm not much for a brown lip color, but today I think I'm going for it. So I'm using Worship. First, I'm gonna draw my Cupid's bow. Then the sides. And now for the bottom part, first the center. And now the sides. And now to finish the eye look, I'm going with my L'Oreal Voluminous Lash Paradise Mascara in Black Brown. And now I'm gonna apply it to my lashes. This is the first coat. I'm doing the top first, and then I'm gonna do the bottom. I'm gonna apply a little bit of the Rose All Day Oil Serum to the tip of my finger. And I think I'm gonna press it to the center of my lips. Yes, I really like this. And to set everything in place, I'm going with my NYX Do It Finish. All right, sweets, this is the final look. I hope you like it. I really like this travel palette. And how my eye look turned out is not that natural, but at least it is a wearable look that we can make, and it's really easy. It's not much about blending, it's just like applying colors and make them look together really nice. So I hope to see you in the next one and that you like this one. Bye.